subscribe to my YouTube channel and click the bell icon for the latest film interviews, features, and recommendations on the movies that matter.
Tapsi Pannu, so good to see you, Tapsi. How have you been? How have you been holding up? I've only been noticing that you're in the mood for throwbacks. I'm looking at social media and you're just remembering the better times.
Actually, I remember when the whole lockdown started, I saw one tweet of Neeraj sir, which said, you know, that it's time to look back at all the pictures that you have in your camera roll and, you know, revisit them. And it did strike a chord with me because every time I see my phone and I go to my pictures, I'm always like, what are these pictures? So many of them. I really want to delete the unnecessary ones and I want to keep the good ones. And when I read that tweet, I was like, this is perfect. This is the perfect time to do that now. And I started revisiting. And I thought instead of, you know, every day putting out those posy pictures of ours, which we do in our regular normal life anyway, why not do this a little differently? Because this is not so normal time. So let's just remember those things, because everyone has kind of paused. Everyone is in that introspection mode. So I guess it's time to like just put out things from the past, which, you know, help you know me slightly better or my life slightly better. So I think that will be different and new and not like regular sexy, hot and beautiful pictures and different ray of light and all that. I think we normally do that a lot. So I thought, let's just do those pictures. So that's why I'm doing those.
Now, you, of course, live in Mumbai with your sister, Shagun. I think you'll have a friend for company. Yes. Is your friend also at home currently? Because I see
Vicky is my sister-in-law, my cousin's wife, and she styles me as well. So she's also there with us. So it's all of us.
Right. Now, what's that like? You know, a house full of three girls. How are you all sort of coping? How are you all dividing up responsibilities? I know that you're one of those who anyway divides chores, domestic chores. You and Shagun, I know, have been doing it. But this is an extraordinary situation. What is this like?
So, Vicky is from America. So, you know, they are used to managing the house by themselves. So, that really easily... we don't even have to like designate, it has organically fallen in place, honestly. So it's not like we started off saying, okay, you will do this, you will do that, you will do this. It so happened that after a couple of days or a week or 10 days or so, it automatically became a routine. Okay. That whoever finds this floor is too bad, because me and Devki work out in the morning. So we find sometimes the floor bad. So either of us will be like, okay, today let me just clean the floor. Or I end up cooking in lunch, and Devki sometimes ends up cooking in dinner. And then Shagun and Devki end up cleaning because I'm cooking. Cleaning the vessels and utensils while I'm cooking. So all these kind of chores are very organically divided. Because when one person is doing something, the other automatically starts doing something else. So then I'm cooking, they help me chop the vegetables so to make the things faster. So it's very organically fallen in place without designating any duty to the other. I'm just a slightly more OCD in terms of cleaning. So I every day find one or the other corner of the house to clean. And that has been a common thing. But other than that, it's very organically without trying fallen in place.
So, Tapsi, you said that you do cook frequently, but I have to ask the question, are you any good in the kitchen? Are you any good at cooking?
So, that one thing that connects me and Amrita of Thappad is that we don't know how to cook. We both don't know how to cook. And at least one thing that's different or not common between us is that at least she tries and she's bad. I don't even want to try. I hate cooking because I don't have the patience to sit, to, you know, stand and stir, to just like slowly wait for it to turn golden brown and all that. I'm like, I don't have the patience for that. But the problem is where I got caught, and it was a catch-22 situation, is that I love to eat and I like to eat good food, and food triggers my mood. So if you don't give me good food, I just have a very silly, stupid day then. So just to have a good day, just for the sake of my mood, just for the sake of my happiness, I had to step into the kitchen. And the one person who's having the last laugh on all of this is my mother. Because she kept telling me for years that, you know, you should learn to cook. I'm like, Mom, I'll find a way to get food done, but I'm not cooking. I mean, I can't even make tea. I'm that wow. bad. So now I have like gone to an extent of making biryanis and keema and butter pepper prawns and I don't know what all exotic dishes.
Wow.
So I have, you name it, and I have made it.
Oh, lovely. Okay. But, yeah. Do you on one level, Tapsee, are you missing work? Because, you know, you're someone who worked a lot. I mean, you've gone from yeah. film to film to film, back to back. And I know that was what you were doing even when this happened. Are you missing being on the set? Because actually for you, that is your most natural environment, isn't it?
It was. I mean, it was sudden break, you know, when which is really against the inertia. Yeah. It did happen very sudden for someone who had chock-a-block schedule of the year. Yeah. And in fact, it was the first time that soon after Haseen Dilruba, I was going to alternate between two films, which I usually don't do. I was going to alternate between Rashmi Rocket and Loop Lapeta, Dhranularan. Mm. So I had to do one sked each because such was the time that I had to finish two films in a limited period of time and I had to alternate. So suddenly when this happened, it was obviously wearing me out in a lot of ways because, you know, when Haseen Dilruba was getting shot, I used to every day wake up at around 5 o'clock in the morning to train for Rashmi Rocket because I had to be in a certain shape and body. And then I used to shoot from 9 a.m. to 9. And then, you know, again, sleep at 10 to wake up at 5. So it was getting pretty grueling for me. And then Thappad release. And then I went back to Haridwar to join that schedule. So it was physically getting very exhaustive. But since I enjoy working out and, you know, being active and I love the films that I've chosen, they are not the ones that I have to force myself on the sets to act. So I kind of was enjoying it anyway. But then this happened. I was like, you know, probably God was like, this time she's not going to get any break between any films. Let me just give her a break. But yeah, so it has been a long break. I haven't got this kind of a break since years. And I really hope this gets over soon because so far I'm keeping fine because I got really busy in doing all these house chores and unwinding myself because it's been really long. I spent time at home. Last year, I barely was at home. So,
and you built this beautiful home, right? You haven't really had a chance to enjoy this home. Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, exactly. So I'm happy that day. But I think this time, 3rd May, if it extends beyond that, even I'll have trouble figuring out what to do to be normal.
Now, you know, one of the films that I'm very fascinated about that you're going to start soon, I think you were meant to start about right about now, is that Run Lola Run remake. You know, Run Lola was really such a fun film. It was that actress was extraordinary, Franka Potente, and really just the whole premise of having to get, I think it was $20 million or 20 million euros in 20 minutes to rescue her boyfriend. Yeah. It's a great premise. What's been the prep for that so far? Have you got into prep for that?
It was so perfectly planned, my schedules, because I was going to do Rashmi Rocket, which is a sprinter story. Correct. And I was going to get into Run Lola Run, which is all about running. So I would have been running. And that fitness would have been taken care of when I entered Shabash Mithu, which was cricket. So once I finished shooting Rashmi Rocket, I was going to start learning cricket a couple of months and then get into Shabash Mithu. So my schedule was just so perfect. Only this could have really messed it up.
Now, your co-star in the Run Lola Run film, which is, I think, called Loop Lapeta right now?
It's called Loop Lapeta.
Loop Lapeta. Nice title. Mm. Now, your co-star in that film is Tahir Bhaseen, who was, of course, in Mardani and who's been in Chichore. Mm. Have you guys met? Has there been any sort of prep, anything? I mean...
So, funnily, we didn't really meet. And the day lockdown was announced in Maharashtra, because it was announced here first. That day we were supposed to meet and have a first reading. I think I would have briefly met him once, like just hi kind of a briefly would have met him somewhere, but not really had a conversation of any sort ever. But I've seen his work. I've seen Mardani. I've seen Chichore. Yeah. So I've seen his work and he's really good. He's really, really good. So when we decided upon which guy and then he came into picture, I was really happy he agreed to do it because I think he's really good.
He is a fine actor. And now since you're saying you haven't met him and you haven't really spent any time figuring out how you're going to do this, let's bring him into this chat. Let me facilitate this sort of, you know, this first meeting.
This will be memorable.
I'm going to try to see if we can get him. He's a good kid. I'm going to try. to see if we can bring him into this. I would imagine he also has sort of some, you know, some preconceived notions about Tapsi Pannu. Now let him meet the real Tapsi. Let's see if we can bring him on. I think we may be in luck. Do we have Tahir?
I think I just hope he doesn't run away after seeing real Tapsi Pannu and he takes it like out.
There he is. There he is.
Hi, Tahir.
Hi, Tapsi. How are you?
So Tahir,
I could never imagine.
Yeah, this way. This being the way.
Yes. Rajiv, we were meant to meet the week of the lockdown. Like, that's when our meeting was supposed to happen. And who knew you would be conducting our first acting workshop?
You know, that is the film ends right here if anyone hears that. Yeah. But Tahir, this is, you know, as I was telling Tapsi earlier, Run Lola Run was really this great film when it came out. It's been some years actually since it came out. Do you remember, actually to both of you, do you remember watching that film? Did y'all watch it in prep for this film, or did y'all already, you know, was that something that y'all had memories of and had already enjoyed it previously?
Tahir, say, did you watch it?
You go, Tapsi.
You know what? People will be like, "Isko kisne actress bana diya?" But let me just tell you. But I heard of it. Funnily, I don't know why, because people just use this phrase "Run Lola Run" or "Run something Run" too often in our regular lives. So I had heard this name, but I didn't know it's a German film. I thought it's just a foreign film, and I didn't know anything about the film. So when they offered it to me is when I saw it. But before that, I had no idea what it is about and what kind of film it is and all. So I saw it later.
Okay. Tahir, had you seen it?
I had seen it in college, and I remember being absolutely blown by it because for its time, it was like so different from anything that had been made. But my question always when something's being remade and it's being remade in India is, how are you going to adapt it? So when I heard the script, I was really excited about the fact that it's not just taking the German concept and making it in Hindi, but it's been adapted to an Indian context in such a way that even the man on the street will understand what was going on in that film. And I think it's going to be really exciting to be doing that, because this was a film that in college, like, I would definitely rank it as one of the things that made me feel like, wow, this would be something that I would want to get into.
Right. Now, Tahir, you've never really met. I mean, Tapsi was saying earlier that y'all haven't actually really got into prep or spent any time together. Are you sort of looking for? I mean, I know she's on the other side, so you can't say anything bad, really. But what are you most looking forward to when it comes to getting?
Think
into
about
this
it, Tahir. You have to.
Yeah,
I have to save you.
Abhi,
I have
to 2 mahine bitane tumhare saath.
What are you sort of looking forward to? I mean, do you have an impression of Tapsi based on the films you watched? She was actually saying some really nice things about you earlier, and I'll allow her.
I like how the nice things about me were said before I came on. So I have no evidence of this until I see the interview.
Correct. Correct.
Yeah.
But you have to believe us. You have to trust us, Tahir. Come on.
No, I like, from everything that I've heard a very genuine person, and what you see is what you get, and I've already seen that in the 2 minutes that we've been on this call, which is great. I already have, because like, it's very hard to work with someone who's got like this layer of pretension or like, you know, trying to be something that they're not. So I've heard, and of course everyone's seen the films, so I've seen her journey from, was it Chashme Badur? Was that?
That was our first Hindi film.
Yes. Yeah. I remember seeing that, and you stood out in that, and then the growth from that, and then Pink and all the films after that. And so I know that she's a hardworking actress and very genuine.
I have not been paid to say this.
You know, I want to ask both of you as actors, is there a way to, because this lockdown has certainly gone on longer than any of us expected. And, you know, while Tapsi is very optimistic and saying May 3rd, Tapsi, I, you know, no one seems to think that that's what it's going to be.
Don't burst my bubble. I'm telling you, you know, I used to have this timer, like not timer. I have this one clipboard on my gallery wall, which every day I used to change, saying, you know, 21 days left, 20 days left. Every day I used to change it and put up a new one there saying these many days left. And when and you should put up an Insta story of that. And then I'll get all my friends, ha ha ha, it's not going to last for that long. It's going to extend. I'm like, why can't people just be happy with my happiness? Why do they have to burst my bubble? Everyone is there ready to burst my bubble all the time. So I stopped putting the Insta stories after some time. And when the lockdown was extended, I added those 21 days. And days I wrote uske niche, ab khush, question mark.
But you're sort of hoping that her timer this time like is really true. May 3rd, yeah, it should be.
Yeah. All of us know that. But I want to ask you, when this lockdown has gone on longer than one is expected, and y'all are certainly missing being on set because that's what you do, that's what makes you most happy. Can this time be productive in any way? Do you find that you're able to be productive in any way? Apart from the, and when I say productive, of course, caring for one's home is productive. But I'm saying in terms of professionally, is there a way to, I was talking to Pankaj Tripathi and he said he's reading a lot of acting books. I mean, there are other people who are doing, Alia was saying she's doing an online creative writing course. Are there ways that you're able to stay productive or that you want to stay productive in this time?
Actually, I am basically catching up on, I'm very bad with catching up films as I just had a glimpse of what I was talking about. I'm very bad with watching films because I don't like watching films on OTT and I'm a theater going person. So when, and with our schedule, it becomes very difficult at times to go to theater and watch a certain film. So this actually I was using to see all the films that I have missed in the last 1 or 2 years, which I have to now watch on OTT. So I was using it for that, which I thought was very productive for me to see what kind of films have been happening and what kind of content is, audience is exposed to. And then, because when you are coming up with a film, you think about your content versus that content because you are coming with them. So, so that is what I was using my time to in terms of productivity, other than the regular jharcha cleaning and safai that was happening at home.
Tahir, have you done anything productive?
Yeah, definitely. Rajiv, when we're not on set, we work from home. So for us, it's not a major change. Like, it's not like we had an office to get to. And so it's we're sort of used to this pattern of being indoors between projects. And definitely, it's been a time to catch up on stuff that you haven't seen on Netflix. I've read quite a bit. Like, normally my attention span is so short because you're always like getting calls or you're on social media. But
mine right now also, it's very short. I don't know how are you guys. There are people like you who read or watch. I have such bad focused retention span with OTT and books.
I literally have to like switch off my Wi-Fi when I want to do something for more than half an hour long. And this lockdown has afforded me the time to do that because where else can you switch off? And of course, like Tapsee was saying, it's given you this whole appreciation for domestic help, for like your security guards, for your spot boy, like the guys who form like the backbone in your everyday life. This is what my politically correct voice is saying. What inside is saying is, someone help me get me out of here.
I saw a meme online which was so perfect in for our times, because remember that K3G Jaya Bachchan's whole thing of Shah Rukh coming and she suddenly as the lockdown opens and the bhai is coming and everyone will be ready with that thali, just having an intuition that she's around ready to just welcome the bhai. It's gonna happen like that for everyone.
Since both of y'all say that y'all have been to different degrees watching stuff, I have to ask you, what have you watched lately that you enjoyed? Give us some recommendations, because everyone is looking for the next binge, or everyone is looking for the next strongly recommended film to watch. What have you seen that you'd recommend to those watching this?
I can see Tapsee's thinking face.
Thank you. Please. I'm very stressed. When they ask me all these intellectual movie questions, I'm very scared of Rajiv and Anupam.
It doesn't have to be.
Intellectual, it can be. We're all also, we're all also watching a lot of films just to raise our spirits. So it can be just stuff that you're enjoying.
The other day I was wondering, all these this content on OTT is just so like crime and suspense, and as if we all gonna just come out of this lockdown as criminals or as really depressed people, because it's just so much of this thriller and suspense content out there, and you rarely find comedy and lighthearted stuff there. But I've just finished watching Don't Fuck With Cats, which has blown my mind. And how, like,
it's so funny she says that. I was watching the same thing. I think we're like there's like a connection there.
You know, for a few hours or more than a day, it was haunting my head that is it for real? And if someone makes a film on it, though the documentary is made in a way, it looks as good as a film. But if someone makes a film on it, they will not believe it. They'll put it aside saying, ye to masala type of film hai, ye to aisa hota hi nahi hai real mein. But what the hell? That was some unreal shit. And the other one was that documentary on the tiger cats. What was the name? I forgot the name.
Tiger King.
Yeah, I saw that. I'm about to finish the second season of Succession. I midway left Killing Eve, so I'm catching up on it again. So yeah, so I think these things come to my head instantly. Yeah. Other than, Homeland is something that I always like to, you know, recommend people to watch because I'm a huge fan of that. That's the only series I've binge watched ever. You know, where you are just back to back, not able to get up after every episode. So that's the only series. Others I can take a break. I don't really mind. But that one was really difficult to take a break in. So yeah, these ones are the ones that are coming top of my head.
Tahir, what are you watching?
I like how Tapsi's named everything I've seen. So now I literally have to make stuff up.
Yeah. So, you can do it. So I will know.
Succession.
Oh, listen,
Succession.
I'll add something to it. I'll add one. The Morning Show on Apple TV. Oh,
yeah.
Ho.
Yeah.
Right.
If you've not seen it, you have to see it. You have to see it.
I'll
the
check
Morning
it
Show.
Yeah. Succession is definitely something like it's so well written and it's an ensemble where every character stands out. If people watching this haven't seen it, I'd really recommend it. I've seen season two, but I won't give Tapsi a spoiler. Uncut Gems. I saw the Adam Sandler film, which is
That's
amazing.
So
and it's so good. And it completely breaks the stereotype that Adam Sandler does.
I'm going to write it down. Wait. Let me just write it
Great.
Down. So I have things to watch. Yeah.
Yeah. And the other one, which is like just also in the sort of dark criminal mind zone, but it's also comedy, is End of the Fucking World, which is an ironic title for what's going on right now. But it's a very good show. And Don't Fuck with Cats. Yeah, I've not seen a documentary like that in forever. The other one is I caught up with Mindhunter season 2, which is very dark but very well made. Yeah.
Finally, I haven't seen Money Heist, but I've heard a lot about it. I haven't seen it. It's the same thing. You know, there was people like, again, look at me in a weird way when I say I haven't seen Game of Thrones.
Same. I haven't seen Game of Thrones.
So everyone around me, like, because it's just so much of it happening that I'm like, okay, let's just let it be. So it was that. And same happened with Money Heist, because when it happened, everybody was like, Money Heist. And I was like, okay, there's too much of it around it. Let me see something else. So I think that's why I haven't caught up on it. But I've been seeing it and there have been people trying to recast it in Hindi. And then I keep getting tagged on it. So I'm like, okay, I really need to see what people expect me to play. So yeah, for that sake, I might just see it sometime, but not anytime soon. I'll look up for something else.
You know, Tahir, I want to quickly ask you, right about this time, or maybe a few weeks earlier, actually, if the world was normal, you'd have been, your film 83 was meant to release, a few weeks ago, in which you're, of course, playing Sunny Gavaskar, you're playing Sunil Gavaskar. Is there a sense of anxiety, a sense of, impatience about this film that you all made with great love and, you know, and great dedication and passion. How do you feel about the fact that now it's going to, you know, you've got to the last leg and now you have to wait?
I'm an optimist, Rajiv. I prefer to see it as half full. I think that we're really lucky that the producers took a call at the right time. The trailer hadn't come out, so no material of the film is actually out there. And I think that it's a timeless concept and it's a period film. So it's not like if the film comes out a few months later, it's going to start looking old. And everyone knows what the concept is. It's a period film anyway. And I think it's going to be a great one to bring the audience back into the theater whenever the producers decide to release it. But I was looking at it the other way. Can you imagine if we'd been in a situation where we were going to shoot it like this April? We're very fortunate. We shot this film in Scotland and in London in a situation where a crew of 200 people moved to the UK for 3.5 months. And there's no way that I'm glad that we've got it in the can and it's ready to go.
Right. Yeah. Can't wait to watch it, by the way. But before we go, Tapsi, Tahir, both of you, I want to ask you the one question I'm asking everyone. when we come out on the other side, you know, when the world goes back to normal, whatever normal is going to mean, whatever this new world is going to be, how do you think you're going to, do you feel like you're going to come out fundamentally changed? And do you feel like all of us are going to come out very different people on the other side?
Not very different. I think, yeah, a little different, as I was telling you before, yeah. That we'll value certain things more than what we used to before. Something as basic as a hug will be valued more. But I
if the person's not got a cold,
it's gonna last. Then it'll be like, it'll be running the other way.
Exactly.
But then, I don't know how long it's going to last, because the other day when I was reading something that Shujit sir wrote on Twitter, which was so true, that, you know, we are the same bunch of people probably, you know, who came out of World War II, and where we thought the world is actually ending. And then here we are again. So it's not like we're going to really be changed human beings for long. But yeah, for some time, maybe. Let's enjoy it till it lasts.
Yeah.
I think the value of human contact and human interaction, there have been times before where I've finished a full day of shooting and friends or family have made a plan and I've avoided it and preferred just staying in and watching something online. But I would now probably make that extra effort to go and hang out with people and take out that time for them, because you've all of a sudden realized how precious that is.
Yeah. I know what you mean. And I'm looking forward to that time when we can go back to doing interviews the way we used to, you know, sitting across from you and talking face to face, because this is all great and technology is fantastic that we can even do this, but there's nothing quite like sitting across from a person and being able to. So I look forward.
But Rajiv, isn't this also great for you? Because people can no longer make an excuse. You've got everyone at home in front of a camera.
Correct. I'm busy. No, you're and not.
No, you're not.
You can make 20 minutes in your day for me.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
We just got to get out of our cages, like, you know, those wild dogs when you suddenly open cage after a really long time. We'll just be running all around. We will just be hote sari. You'll just go and sit on the road. Just out. I don't want to go back.
But listen, I want to say to y'all, you know, this is a great chemistry. I feel like, and there's such mutual respect. I feel like,
High five.
Thank you for our first workshop, Rajiv.
I'm buying a ticket to your movie. Whenever you guys get down to making it and releasing it, you have one ticket sold already. And I feel like this is a film that a lot of people will be very excited to watch. So all the best on the film, of course. But meanwhile, stay safe, stay healthy, stay indoors. And the next time we do this in person, the next time I guess we'll be talking about your film when we're all together and in person the next time. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you. All the best. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Bye.
See you, Rapti.
Bye-bye.